Hello students, today we are going to learn adjectives. What is an adjective? An adjective is a word which describes a noun, or you can say a word that tells you more about a noun or gives you more information about a noun in the sentence is known as adjective. For example, they live in a house. Here we have they as a subject, live as the verb, in as the preposition, house as a noun. But if I use beautiful in the sentence will be like this. They live in a beautiful house. Here, house is a noun and beautiful is telling you more about house, that what type of house it is. It is a beautiful house. So basically, an adjective is a word which is or which describes a noun and tells you more about the noun. So let's move further. Kinds of adjective. Adjectives can be different types depending on the type of information they give about a noun or a pronoun. It can be adjective of quality, adjective of quantity, demonstrative adjective, interrogative adjective, possessive adjective, adjective of number, and proper adjectives, emphasizing adjectives. Here in this chapter, we are going to learn several things about adjectives, but let's talk about the kinds of adjective first. So what are or what does adjective of quality tells us in the sentence? Adjective of quality describe the quality of a noun as shape, size, color, state, or condition. They answer the question, what kind of? For example, Neeta does not like the smell of ripe jackfruit. Draw a big circle. Here the word ripe and big describes the nouns jackfruit and circle respectively. Further, we have adjectives of quantity. They tells you the quantity of a noun. They answer the question, how many in the case of countable nouns and how much in the case of uncountable nouns. I have many friends. There are several students waiting to meet the principal. Here the words many and several describes the nouns friends and students respectively. Later in the video we have demonstrative adjectives. What are they? Demonstrative adjectives are used to point out a specific noun or a pronoun. The four demonstrative adjectives are this, that, these and those. Basically, they tell you that where the noun or the pronoun or the point, they point out the noun or the pronoun in the sentence. For example, this argument is convincing. That girl is very tall. So here, noun, argument and girl are being pointed out by the demonstrative adjectives, that is this and that respectively. Next we have interrogative adjectives. Now what are they? Again, interrogative are the words which are asked or which are used to ask questions. Interrogative adjectives are used to ask questions and are always followed by a noun. Keep this in mind that there are interrogative pronouns as well, but do not get confused. We will discuss about it in the next video when we learn the pronouns. Here, let's talk about interrogative adjectives first. Interrogative adjectives are used to ask questions. For examples, which topic are you going to talk about? Whose papers are you checking? What problems are you facing? Here you can see that what comes before a noun, but when the interrogative words are used as pronoun, the interrogative pronoun will be followed or will be preceded by a verb only. Here we have the next kind, that is possessive adjectives. Now what are possessive adjectives? Yes, possessive means to show ownership. They basically demonstrate the ownership. Here let's get to know what are they. Possessive adjectives indicate ownership or possession and always come before the noun. Yes students, keep this in mind that possessive adjectives always placed before a noun. They answer the question whose. For example, their children live in the USA. Her son is studying in Chennai. My parents are arriving today. Here the words their, her, my are possessive adjectives or the examples of possessive adjectives. You can see that they are preceded by a noun only. Their children, here children is the noun. Now next we have adjective of number. As you can understand that the adjectives which tells you the number of a noun are known as adjective of number. Let's talk about the definition first. Adjectives of number indicate the number of the noun. They are of four types, that can be indefinite, distributive, cardinals or ordinals. Now what are they? Indefinite adjectives and distributive adjectives, what are they basically? Indefinite adjectives don't specify a particular number basically. Some people are there, give me any pen. So here some and any do not tell you any specific number. That's why they are indefinite adjectives. Distributive adjectives, as we have learned that they don't, distributive adjectives are used to refer to a person or a thing separately. For example, each student was given a kit, neither of them is friendly. So here the word each or neither, they are distributive adjective as they are pointing out a person separately. Next we have cardinal numbers and ordinal numbers. They are easy. Basically you have learned them several of times. Cardinal numbers mention the exact number of the noun. Like I have 3 friends. Do you have 20 rupees? So here 3 or 20 and 20 both are cardinal numbers, whereas ordinal numbers mention rank, position or order of a noun in a series. For example, Rahul is the first boy to reach school. This is the third time I am calling you. Here the words first and third tells you the rank or the position of a noun in the sentence. Now let's move further and talk about proper adjectives. Now what are they? Proper adjectives are formed from proper nouns. Do you remember what are proper nouns? Yes, the proper nouns are the nouns which tells you or which gives you the specific name of a noun. Here in proper noun, what do we have? In proper adjective, what do we have? I love Shakespearean dramas. My uncle married to an Irish woman. I love to have Indian cuisine. Here the word Shakespearean, Irish and Indian are the proper adjectives because they are formed from a proper noun like Shakespeare, India, etc. Next we have emphasizing adjectives. Now what does emphasizing means? Emphasizing means to give more importance to something. So with the help of emphasizing adjectives, what can we do in a sentence? Emphasizing adjectives are used to lay stress on a noun. Here if you have a noun in your sentence and you want to make it more specific or more emphatic, you will be using emphasizing adjectives there. For example, माइंड योर ओन बिजनेस, इज़ दैट योर एक्चुअल नेम? हेयर बिजनेस एंड नेम बोथ आर नाउन्स, एंड टू मेक और टू पुट मोर स्ट्रेस ऑन अ नाउन वी यूज एम्फेसाइजिंग एडजेक्टिव्स हियर बाय यूजिंग द वर्ड्स ओन एंड एक्चुअल रिस्पेक्टिवली. Later in the chapter, you will be able to learn the formation of adjectives. Keep this in mind that the adjectives can be formed from nouns and verbs also. Like, for example, anger is a noun and we can make angry from the noun anger, and angry is your adjective. Danger, dangerous. Danger is a noun and dangerous is adjective. From verbs, how can we make adjectives? The verb here we have is accept. Accept can be used as acceptable, and create can be used as creative. Then next we have the topic compound adjectives. What are compound adjectives? First, let us talk about the meaning of compound. Compound means the mixture of two commodities. So here, if we are talking about compound adjectives, that means we might have two adjectives at the same time. A compound adjective is formed when two or more words are joined together to modify the same noun. The words are usually separated with a hyphen. Hyphen you can call a dash also. He submitted a 10-page assignment. Don't give me half-baked cookies. They have a 2-year-old daughter. Here the words half-baked and 2-year-old daughter are your compound adjectives. Let's move to the next topic, that is the order of adjectives. Yes, students. When you have multiple number of adjectives in a same sentence, you might get confused that which adjective needs to be or comes at the first place, or what would be the sequence of the adjective. Here, with this table, you can get to know that first, on the first place, we'll be using quantity, then general opinion about the noun, then specific. If there is no general opinion, there might be any specific opinion, then we can put that. Then if there is any size of the noun, then you can put size. Just like that, if you have temperature, shape, age, color, nationality, material given, then you will follow the sequence which is given there in the table. For example, we can say they have a ferocious big 2-year-old black dog. Here ferocious is the specific opinion, big is your size, 2-year-old is your age, black is the color, and dog is your noun. Now last topic in the chapter is degrees of comparison. Yes, students, in the classroom you might meet people with different abilities or qualities. Like, some of your friends can be taller than you or shorter than you. So what do we do there? We compare each other, or we compare ourselves to each from everyone. Here in this chapter you are going to learn about the degrees of comparison. Have you heard hot, hotter, hottest, quite, quieter, quietest, tall, taller, tallest? Yes, you are getting it right. We are going to learn the three degrees of comparison, that is positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree of adjective. These degrees will make you differentiate or compare, make you able to compare between or among different kind or different sizes or different type of things. Like, if you have a friend who is quite beautiful or more beautiful than you, then how will you speak? Like, Smita is a beautiful girl. But if you find Rita more beautiful than her, then how will you make the sentence? Smita is beautiful. Rita is more beautiful than Smita. But if you find Geeta the most beautiful one, then you will be speaking that Geeta is the most beautiful girl in the whole classroom. So basically, what do you learn? You have learned that positive degree is used when there is no comparison at all. We are using or we are telling about a simple noun. But when we have two nouns in a sentence and we have to compare, there we will be using comparative degree of adjective. But when we have number of nouns or number of more than three nouns in the sentence and we have to compare them, the superlative degree will be used there.